There she is. Let's add her in.
Da-da-da-da-da. I feel like I need some kind of like drum roll. You guys drum roll with me.
Hi.
There she is.
Hello. I'm so sorry. 50 minutes late. Another interview went over. I'm so sorry.
That is okay. How are you?
I'm good. I'm usually very punctual. I'm sorry. So sorry about that.
That is totally fine. Well, welcome to the lunch table. I'm having lunch here. So if you
have food.
Go
Look at
for
your
it.
Food. It looks like cafeteria, but you got your beans and your carrots. Oh, no, those are almonds.
These are almonds. I'm really into like toasts and stuff right now and like nut butters. So yes. I'm just, don't mind me if I'm eating during this.
I love almond butter. That's my favorite.
So good. What's going on at your house? What's the snack situation? Have you guys even had lunch? Is that you're having to do all that now?
Usually it's kind of a combination. You know, it's me and my husband and our three kids, and then we were smart enough, because I knew I was gonna have to work from here with all the jobs, we actually brought my nanny Allie, who's irreplaceable, like she's so amazing. And but we kind of switch it up. She doesn't cook generally, she hates cooking, but I do like most cooking.
Okay.
And my husband will grill sometimes, but we are constantly cooking, like every meal, every snack. We're cleaning constantly, plus doing all the jobs, plus you know, trying to find the missing iPad. And it's like,
it's like, oh, I'm no, look like, in the couch cushions. I keep finding stuff in the couch
or
cushions.
Just look anywhere but here, because I don't care right now. Like, go find your own iPad.
How are you managing all this stuff? Because you're a mom, recording artist, talk show host, you're a teacher, I guess, at this point.
Shoot. I've been saying this my entire life, but because my mom's a teacher, she's a retired teacher, and they're so underpaid. And now people are probably listening, because nobody realizes how hard it is to not only be able to be aware of what you're teaching, but to keep the attention, like the attention span of a child is like of a gnat. So like, it's, you know, it's really hard. But my nanny's been killing it on that front, because usually their school time, they have to zoom in at a certain time.
Okay.
And I'm working. So mostly Allie's handling that. And I think she's definitely had several of bottles of wine since she's been here.
What's like the pantry snack situation? Because I have a pantry right here, and I'm just snacking, I think, all day on like chips and cereal and obviously nuts and vegetables.
My favorite, I mean, I know this sounds healthy. We have unhealthy ones too, but my favorite snack is beets and goat cheese. Oh my God.
Whoa.
You just warm them up in a little saucepan. Like it's, I know it sounds fancy. It's not, it's, they're canned because we're in a pandemic. So it's not like they're from our garden or something.
Right. Totally.
But it's really good. My daughter and I love it because, you know, during a pandemic, everybody just takes everything and you're not supposed to go to the grocery store often. So, and we have a teenager, you know, so he's loved too. So, and it's just one of those things that my daughter and I only like beets, so nobody else eats them.
Interesting. Well, there you go. What about games? Are you guys playing any board games at home right now? Because I love the time to play games with the family.
I do too. I love Clue is the one we usually go to, or Rummy Cube. But we haven't actually played a ton recently, just because there's been so much work and school. So usually by the time, you know, we're down and we're all eating dinner, usually it's napped. I mean, it's bedtime for the kids right after that, and we're reading and, you know, going through that routine. So there hasn't been a whole lot of time for that.
Wow.
I know that sounds funny, because people are like, oh, what are you going to do? You're so bored in your pandemic. I'm like, if you're bored during the pandemic, that means that either one, you're single, or you don't have kids. Because I am definitely not bored.
Yeah. Well, I love that you've had time to put out music, which I guess this song, I Dare You, you planned to put this out anyways.
Yeah.
So the timing was just, it just is what it is. But when did the idea for this song, I Dare You, happen?
Well, I've had the song for a little over a year, and I fell in love with it. And I just thought it was a really cool song. I knew I'd be able to like soar in certain parts, and I love an empowering anthem. And I honestly, the whole idea of singing in different languages was just because I grew up singing in different languages, and I grew up singing opera. And so it was like, I thought this should come in handy at some point, right? Like, I'm not just doing this for nothing. So I never sang in Hebrew or Arabic, but I had sang in German, French, and Spanish before. But it was really difficult. And the idea was, I wanted to work with artists from all over the world on it. I thought the message in the song was bigger than just one artist and one territory. I thought it was a really cool, important message before the pandemic. And now it seems like even more pertinent in this time. So it was a really crappy thing as an artist have to wait so long to get a project to finally come to fruition. But man, the fact that it did take so long and it happened perfectly in this time was kind of a universe God thing. So
yeah. Is this song the same that it was before the current situation, or did you change it up at all?
No, it's exactly
the same.
Yeah, wow. It was exactly how it's supposed to. That's what I'm saying. It was insane that, like, we're so globally connected, and our whole, you know, ambitious thought with this project was to globally connect everyone. So couldn't have been a more perfect kind of scenario to release a message that is so important.
Yeah. I love that you have an Instagram filter for the song now too. That's cute.
Oh, I know. They were like, you want to do an Instagram live with heart things? I was like, sure. I was like, let's do it.
Yeah. Like, why not? Are you down to take a couple of fan questions real quick? I know you have a really busy day. No, okay. I had some come through while we were getting ready. Aaron wants to know, what's the latest you've stayed in your PJs during all this work from home life?
Like 48 hours.
Okay.
I'm working, so I definitely have to at least have a top on that is not a pajama part right. of a pajama set. But no, I'm usually always rocking Carhartts, honestly, like overall Carhartts, because I'm on a ranch. So and it's snowing and it's muddy, and so usually you have completely different.
Okay. Do you have ranch duties now in addition to all the other things we were talking about?
Oh no, I that's my husband's world. My duty is definitely just nailing what we're doing now and kiddos. And I mean, we have like stuff that we're going to be doing. We bought the ranch a little under a year ago. So the only thing we have running on it right now is my husband's cattle operation. He started. So it's awesome. Actually, it's calving season. So there's little baby calves like just running around, and they're so cute. Yeah. So, it's really kind of a low key setting right now, because we haven't really built much here yet. So
yeah, totally makes sense. What about your birthday? Isn't your birthday coming up next week?
Yeah.
Are you going to celebrate?
Son just had his, and mine's happening. Honestly, I'm going to be. There anymore. So I'm totally cool with a chill, you know, time with my family. That's like what I would ask for anyway. Yeah. So I did get a truck. My husband bought me a truck. He surprised me with buying it because I don't have a car here. So, and really the cars are not helpful in this environment. So, yeah. So I did get an F-250 for my birthday. So,
well, happy early birthday, Kelly.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yes. Well, we're going to let you go. I know you have a busy day, but the song is called I Dare. You were playing it on Radio Disney. It's so beautiful. I love multilingual versions that you release. So congratulations. We need this artist to bring hope and happiness during this time. So thank you for the beautiful song.
No, thank you so much. And good luck with all your snacks.
Thanks. I'm going in. We'll talk to you later, Kelly.
Okay, bye.
Bye, girl.